Welcome to the video tutorial lessons on econometrics. In today's lesson, we are going to talk about introduction and methodology of econometrics. Econometrics literally means economic measurement. And actually, it is the metrics aspect of the word that means measurement. However, econometrics goes beyond just measurement and is actually the application of mathematics and statistics with economic theory. But if we would like to look at a more concrete definition of econometrics, then we want to consider one that was given by Arthur in 1964, where econometrics is defined as a social science in which the tools of economic theory, which are mathematics and statistics, are applied to the analysis of economic phenomena. And so we would like to consider the methodology of econometrics. There are actually about three of them, but we want to consider the traditional or classical methodology of econometrics. And because it is the most commonly used one, there are about 8 steps of this methodology. And the first one is the statement of theory or hypothesis. So anytime you want to model in econometrics, there should be a statement of theory. And so we are most familiar with this famous theory of demand, which states that quantity demanded is inversely related to price, ceteris paribus. And we all know that the ceteris paribus actually stands for all things being equal. Another famous theory is the consumption theory, which states that consumption is positively related to income. So if we should take into consideration the second theory, where consumption is positively related to income, then we transition to the next step of the methodology, which is specifying the mathematical model. So to specify the mathematical model for the consumption theory, it is of the form C equals A plus BY, where C is consumption expenditure, Y is income, A and B are parameters, and actually they represent the intercept and slope respectively. But in the theory, the A stands for autonomous consumption, and B is marginal propensity to consume, MPC for short. So after specifying the mathematical model, then you specify the econometric model. So a typical econometric model of the consumption theory is of the form Y equals beta 1 plus beta 2 X plus U. And if we should compare this econometric model with the mathematical model, then we would normally see that the Y actually represents the C, which is the consumption. The beta 1, that is the intercept or the autonomous consumption, is there. And we also have the beta 2, that is the slope. And we have the X in the econometric model, which stands for the income. So in such a case, there is also another parameter. And that parameter is called the unobserved factors, because there are other factors that also affect the consumption level, such as the size of the family, employment level. All these also affect the consumption level. And so because we did not capture that in the econometric model, they all find their way into the U parameter, which is the unobserved factors. Normally in econometrics, we call the U also as the error term or the disturbance term, and we shall understand that later on. So the next step after the econometric model is to obtain the data, and data can likely be obtained from the Ghana Statistical Service. It can also be obtained from the World Bank or World Development Indicators. Sometimes the researcher may want to obtain primary data by going to the field and administering questionnaires, conducting interviews, and that is also where you can get the data. But basically, when you get the data, you use the data now to estimate the econometric model. So what you need to do is, this is the model, the econometric model we specified earlier. So after obtaining the data, we estimate this model. And so we would get the values. Let's assume the values are actually beta 1 is 17.24 from the data, and beta 2 is 8.97. If we fix this into the econometric model, we get the estimated model to be Y equals 17.24 plus 8.97X. Okay. So right at this point, then the next step after estimating the econometric model is to conduct hypothesis testing. And why would hypothesis testing be important in this case? We need that to test for the significance of the model or the parameters you have estimated. So in such a case, we might want to question whether our parameters, the beta 1 value and the beta 2 estimates we have had, are actually significant or not. But this must follow the formulation of a hypothesis. So we state the hypothesis, and with the null hypothesis stating that the parameter is not significant, and the alternative also states that the parameter is significant. If we manage to find enough evidence and we reject the null hypothesis, then it means that our parameter becomes significant. And when that is satisfied, you can move to the next step, which is the forecasting and prediction. So in such a case, with this econometric model, if we should assume that this particular year, income is actually 12, so x equals 12, we fix this into the model and we can obtain the value as 124.88. But then if we should assume that next year or the following year, income level is going to be 30, then we can estimate the consumption level at that particular income level. So we substitute this into the model and we also get to 86.34. So once your model goes through the forecasting and prediction, then you can use the model now for control or policy purposes. So sometimes, for instance, we can consider that the government may be interested in determining the level of income that will keep the consumption expenditure at a certain amount. So the government can use this model for such policy purposes and actually can adopt the tools of fiscal policy and monetary policy through the central bank and all of that. And we can use such model for the formulating of policies. And when that is satisfied, actually, this is the methodology of econometrics, and we can look at the summary of the lesson so far. So if we should summarize what we have done so far, it looks like in the methodology of econometrics, the first step is to formulate an economic theory. Then you move to the mathematical model of the theory specified. So after specifying the mathematical model, then you specify the econometric model of the theory, after which you need to obtain the data, then use the data obtained to estimate the econometric model. Then you test the hypothesis to determine whether the model is significant or the parameters you have estimated are significant. Then after that, you can use the model for forecasting or prediction. And when that is also satisfied, you can move ahead to use the model for control or policy purposes. So this is actually the methodology of econometrics. And I hope you found this lesson useful. Thank you and have a nice day.